Hello, Dissenters. Etalyx here, number one slime scientist, ready for the finale of the slime science update. The slime hoop, the most difficult to craft curio of them all, is going to be mine today. But not yet, because we do not have the necessary royal jelly. And don't worry, I'm not going to force you to watch tens, twenties, thirties, hundreds, potentially, apiaries being cracked open to reveal disappointment. We're gonna try and skip through this, so this video will probably be a little bit shorter. But you might notice that we have a brand new corral over here. I figured why not take advantage of some of the little fields that have become available in this new sector. And to that end, I think I would like a garden. I probably should have saved at least one carrot, but I will be coming back to this. So we're beefing it up with some nutrient soil. If I had enough money, we need 9 more coins. So I will be back, my pink slime friends. We've already got 90 different ports here. For some reason, it thinks I need a tutorial on how to operate gardens. How strange. All right, with these 50 ports, we're gonna be able to build a few more apiaries and take a look, of course, to remind ourselves of what it actually takes to make these cool decorations and curios. Now, I remember we did unlock the amber slime lamp the other day, and that needs phosphor plorts, honey plorts, buzzwax, and indigonium. We have all of those. So I say, let's go ahead and build that decoration right now just to look at something new. And for the slime ball hoop, we're gonna need one hunter plort, easy. Some tabby plorts, very easy. Got the jellystone, 2 spiral steam, and 2 royal jelly. The only threat here is, of course, the royal jelly. And then for other decorations, I might be able to make a mossy tree with the honey plort and the minty grass with a few puddle plorts. So we are on the fast track to getting some cool new stuff to look at. And more importantly, I think I remember where that level 2 treasure chest is. I really want to see what's inside. Now, first I need to get this off my screen. You know what? I'm just going to plant the heartbeat in the garden so that this tutorial goes away. And then we're going to hop through the teleporter and take a look and see if the apiaries are ready yet. All right, we're growing that type. I've done the tutorial. Leave me alone. They may not be ready because we just planted some down not too long ago. Yep, they've got another 9 minutes before we can harvest, and it was that easy to check on them. That is why the teleporters are amazing. I think my friends the crystal slimes here. Oops. Uh-oh. I have made a mistake. Let's just dump the fossils on the ground for now so that we don't cause a problem with the phosphor slimes trying to make hybrids. Maybe I should hybridize these guys. What do you think? Should we make some crystal rad slimes? That does sound pretty cool. I want to see what that looks like. I mean, we've got 50 crystal ports almost. Why not use a few of them over here? These poor rad slimes have been so lonely, haven't they? None of them really get the care or attention or the food that they deserve. Ooh, big spiky rad slime, who are also very angry. They jump and they make big spikes and they spin and they're radioactive. Really just all the worst possible traits here. For those of you who are following along at home, it's now day 55. You can rest assured that every time that day counter at the top left of the screen ticks up by 1, I have checked every apiary, every drill, every pump, looking for something, looking for that royal blue jelly and creating more extractors to fill in the gaps left by those that disappear. It's not an easy job, but somebody has to do it. 2 at once again. One of you has to be lucky one of the times. Actually, 2 of the times. Because we don't need just 1 royal jelly. No, we need 2 for the slime ball hoop. I can't even get 1. Much less 2, and there's another apiary just disappeared. Okay, well, another day then, perhaps. So since we're just spending so much time hoping, what say we decorate the area a little bit? I've got an amber slime lamp. I'll install it right here. Kind of forgot about it. We built that a while ago, didn't we? This almost feels evil. I don't feel good about this. I feel like I've just trapped a honey slime inside of a jar of honey. Now, I'll have infinite honey. You can never stop producing it. Oh, life ain't what it used to be, is it, honey slime? Before we go, just in case any of the apiaries disappear, see if we can craft one or two more. Looks like we have enough for one. We're gonna have to go get some more honey plorts. All right, but one is better than none. Show me what you got. There it is. I told one, starting with one. Another royal jelly. Finally. Please let there be a second one. What if I got like a second and a third? There's still four more opportunities for royal jelly. So starting with the first apiary giving us a royal jelly is as good as we could possibly hope for. I'm depending on you guys. I wonder if there was some kind of overriding percentage chance, like if it knows, like a legendary drop rate. I hope not. Was there 25 more seconds on this one? That's gonna be number six. Here's number five, and apparently there are some tar slimes in the area. I'm still excited about that royal jelly, but I still know that I have to get one more. Let it be you. Let it be 7 seconds. Lucky number seven. But lucky number six in this case, because you're the sixth apiary. I'm hitting E immediately, so you don't even have time to say no. Okay, whatever. Fine. I'll be back for another royal jelly soon enough. It is day 58, but it is the last day. For the royal jelly hunt is finally over. I have no need to wait two more minutes for either of you apiaries, even though you might have some delicious jelly within you. I don't know, it's unlikely. And there vanishes yet another apiary. Many days later. Oddly, I have got royal jelly before I have even gotten the rare resource from pumps. I guess that's because I don't have quite as many pumps. There's only like one or two working for me right now. So statistically, it makes sense. But it's time for celebration. It's time to get 65 tabby plorts to make the slime ball hoop. You know what? I bet you that there are already over 65 tabby plorts waiting for us. Unfortunately, that means it's gonna take more than one trip. Because I can only fit 50 tabby plorts. Yeah, 196. 100 rock, 96 tabby. More than enough. No need to wait any longer. I can't believe it's finally happening after all this time. To celebrate, we're not just going to put down the slime ball hoop. Oh, it feels good to craft that. We're also going to hit up the mossy tree. Well, it looks like we actually need a few more honey plorts to do that, but the minty grass patch is within our grasp. Oh, and I forgot about that tier 2 chest, which should be just past the skull and crossbones, nestled safe and sound, right? Oh, do we not buy that? Crap. 9,400 new bucks. The tier 2 treasure cracker. It's mine. And that should be the very last upgrade. Let's go crack that chest. So where were we? Yes, that's right, the skull and the crossbones and the tier 2 super treasure chest. I would be remiss if I did not open this after revealing it earlier on. New blueprint, a spring pad launches anything that touches it straight into the air. I thought that the slime hoop was as good as it gets, but now we can use the spring pad to launch slimes into the slime hoop. There's a combination there. Let's find out how expensive the spring pad could possibly be. It's not a curio. It's not a decoration, warp tech, but it is a utility. Wow, easily affordable, I think. Let's buy one. Now let's head back to the center part of the ranch, the old school part. I like the lab area, I do. But I don't see the need to decorate it quite so much. Now, if I was going to put a tree down somewhere, where do you think that would go? Not in the middle, certainly. The middle is probably where the basketball hoop is gonna go. Ah, I got an idea. We're gonna do basketball hoop over here. Facing this direction, I guess? Huh, how about facing the stairs? I guess the orientation that you build this is very important. We're gonna build the best first. Here comes the hoop. What is our high score? I guess it keeps track. Well, this is gonna be real fun. We're gonna need an army of pink slimes to shoot. I forgot to pick up my pink slime friends. And in the other spot, I wanna put the spring pad. So so that we can bounce the slimes off of it into the hoop. That's the goal. And now for the tree and the grass. How about we throw the tree? I don't know, actually. What about the grass as well? Maybe the tree can go in the middle, but that's kind of odd, I think. Let's put the tree right here, I guess. I don't know. It's gonna be the same thing no matter what, really. And we can build multiple trees if we really wanted to. It's a little out of place, but that's okay. And maybe a tiny patch of grass towards the entrance. This is probably gonna look really out of place. Well, you're telling me you're not that interested in the round little patch of grass? And you wanna focus on shooting some hoops instead? With our number one talented slime? How long is this gonna take to build? We'll look at the spring shortly. Let's focus on shooting some hoops. Off the backboard. Nothing but net. What a satisfying sound that is. It even starts like action music and the goal starts rotating and going up and down to make it more difficult. Oh, come on, don't run around the rim on me like that. Let's go get more slimes. This is gonna be great. And now we've got 40 different pink basketballs. I'm coming back. And maybe this spring will be ready for us to try out. Let's see. Has it finished installing? Has it finished construction? It has! Okay, so we can't use it quite the way I want it to. Maybe we can. Not enough distance, unfortunately. I don't know how to make that work. There might be a way, though. All right, so hear me out here. What if we take a running jump onto the spring, bounce, and then shoot, but don't completely miss the backboard. I guess that's so we don't have to use our jetpack. I'm not sure what really makes this a utility, nor am I sure how to properly shoot from this distance. This is gonna take a little practice. Any day now. There's one. It's harder than it looks, okay? Goodbye, pink slime. My planet needs me. All right, let's do this for real. We got 26 more pink slimes. The last time we had a whole bunch of slimes out here, though, remember what happened? Yeah, that disaster of a talent show. Also, am I really this bad at shooting? There, that's more like it. If you just shoot enough pink slimes, you can't miss. We need more ammunition. Some of them are getting away. Why is the music so hardcore while we're doing this, too? Actually, the fact that it turns and raises up and down does make this a lot more difficult, so you can't just rapid fire shoot. You have to adjust your aim ever so slightly and they bounce off of the backboard. Quite hard. A lot of reflections there, and then they stack up on top of each other. I used to play basketball, okay? Believe me. I managed to get 22 points. Nothing to really be proud of, but the aftermath is outrageous. It's like 52 card pickup. The pink slimes are everywhere. They do not want to be gathered, and they are inside the chicken coop again. They're making plorts, eating all of our heartbeats. Well, guys, I think we've done everything that we can here in the Slime Science Update for Slime Rancher. Definitely the best update so far. A little grindy for some of the rare components, I confess, but it gave me something to do. It gave me a reason to dive in day after day, keep trying to achieve that wonderful curio. The slime basketball hoop, and it's a lot of fun. This one is way better than Talent Show. This is better than the number one slime, by far. Hope you all have enjoyed this mini-series, taking back to the world of Slime Rancher in the name of science. Let me know what you think about the update in the videos, please, down in the comments below. I'd appreciate that very much. I'm sure there's more treasure out there to be cracked, but this is what I was able to find. And I hope you appreciated that. Thank you all so much for watching. My name is Etalyx. I'll see you next time. Beat my new high score if you can.